couple of summers ago, I got the opportunity to go with the Telos group to Israel to learn and engage in the conflict that is happening right now in Israel with Israel and the Palestinian people. And I went just to learn and to dialogue and hear stories. I met with so many wonderful people, from Christian Palestinians who have been forced out of their homes from settlements, to wonderful Muslim Palestinians who are working for peace, to wonderful Jewish Israelis who also long for peace and for justice. While I was there, I got to go see refugee camps. I got to go play some music in Bethlehem as well as stay in Jerusalem. And it was a trip that was life-changing for me. But it was a heartbreaking trip. And while I was there, one afternoon after visiting Yad Vashem, which is the Holocaust Museum, we went to the top of the Mount of Olives, and you can see the entire city of Jerusalem from the Mount of Olives. And this is the place where in Scripture it says that Jesus looked over the city of Jerusalem and wept. And so we're standing there and kind of just reflecting on our afternoon after feeling like I could cry no more tears after visiting the Holocaust Museum. Here we are, and our tour guide says, if you look to your left, you'll see all of these tombs. These are Jewish tombs on this hill, because Jewish families will send their loved ones from all around the world to be buried here because they believe that the Messiah will come on this hill. And so as you make your way down the hill into the valley, there are more tombs. There are Christian tombs, because Christians have believed that Jesus will return on this hill. And as you make your way from the valley up to the wall of Jerusalem, there are more tombs that are Muslim tombs, because in the Muslim faith, they believe that Jesus will return on this hill. So we sat on the top of the Mount of Olives, looking at the city, looking at these tombs, and I thought of all the beautiful people that I had met on our journey, on this trip, and all of their tragic, heartbreaking stories, as well as reflecting on all of the wonderful things that Jewish and Christian and Muslim people have done for art and for beauty and advancing science and technology, and then also reflecting on all of the ugliness from war, from suicide bombings, from terrorism, through the Crusades, through all of these things we have done in the name of religion against one another. And so I get home from this trip and I try to write, and I just get writer's block to where I couldn't write a song for about 5 months. And it was November leading up into our Advent tour, and my daughter, who was 2 years old at the time, went up to the piano and she played these three notes, da da da. And right when I heard those three notes, somehow I was like back on that hill, back on the top of the Mount of Olives. And I thought about all the people that I had met along the way. And I thought about that story of everyone in some form or another longing for the Messiah, or longing for the Messiah to return, or just longing for Jesus to return. And I, out of that place, sat down at the piano and wrote Yahweh. And it's a song, an Advent song, that is a song that in one way laments and also cries out for Yahweh and for God the Father and for Jesus in some form or another, to hear the cry of humanity, hear the cry of these people groups, and the longing for peace. That's the story of Yahweh.